Our first purchase of inventory will be by check. This means we are paying immediately and receiving the merchandise at the moment that we pay. What happens when you pay immediately when buying inventory? Well, as we said before, the inventory asset will increase because inventory asset holds the purchase cost of the inventory that we currently have. If we pay money to buy the merchandise at the moment we receive it, cash in bank will go down by the amount that we pay for the merchandise. Inventory has a separate area of reports just to track the change in quantity. The best inventory report for you to look at is the inventory valuation detail. Let's open it up before we record any transactions. From the main menu, click Reports, Inventory, and then go to Inventory Valuation Detail. As a general policy in this course, always change the pull-down date to all transactions regardless of date. Right now, the report is empty, but every time you buy a particular item of inventory, you will see that specific item listed here with an increase in the quantity, and every time you sell a particular item of inventory, you will see the item listed on another line with a minus to the quantity. Our first purchase transaction will be May 18. We paid Addie's Orchard by check, which means we paid immediately to buy 20 apples, and we wrote Addie check number 220. Therefore, we will have to add Addie's Orchard to the vendor list at the moment we write the check. We've done this before. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Banking, write a check. Now we put the date, May 18. We put the vendor, adding at the moment that we record the check, Addie's Orchard, and you can fill in the details later. Click OK. Now, do not, I repeat, do not put any money amount in the money field. Instead, click the Items tab and choose the merchandise item you're buying, apples. Notice, QuickBooks remembers that apples has a purchase cost of $10 each. We put in the quantity, it's actually telling us the quantity on hand by clicking this little box. However, we need to enter the quantity as 20 and push tab. After we push tab, QuickBooks will calculate the amount of the check by multiplying the quantity times the purchase cost. If the purchase cost were different, we would change this number, but we will leave it for now. So we are buying more apples for $200, and cash in bank is going down by $200. When we click Save and Close, we can take a look at our inventory report. Inventory valuation detail shows just only apples with a value of $200. The trial balance shows after our first inventory purchase, inventory asset shows up in the trial balance for the very first time as $200. If you need an explanation of what that $200 is in inventory, you can always take a look at the inventory valuation detail, and it will tell you each transaction and the quantity and the item. Now let's see what the reports look like after our second purchase. Imagine on May 19th, we paid Sam's Farm by check for 30 bananas. That means we will also have to add Sam's Farm to the vendor list at the moment we write the check. So here we are back at the inventory valuation detail. Here is our trial balance. Banking, write a check. May 19th, Sam's Farm, we don't have them on the list, so we click Add New, click OK, and type in Sam's Farm, and then click OK. Now Sam's Farm is on the list. Do not put the money amount in the money field. If you are buying merchandise, QuickBooks will calculate the money amount. You do not use the expense tab. You use the items tab. Choose the bananas that we put in the items list. Notice QuickBooks remembers that we have $20 purchase cost per item. We could always check the current quantity by clicking the quantity box. In this case, there's nothing because this is our first purchase. Next to the quantity box, we type in the amount, the number of how many bananas we're buying. After we push tab, QuickBooks calculates the amount of the check should be $600 because it's $20 a banana and we told QuickBooks we're buying 30 bananas. When we click save and close, we can see the inventory valuation detail shows. Let's open it up a little. Let's see what it shows. It shows that we have 20 apples on hand. We have 30 bananas on hand. That means we have $200 worth of apples on hand. We have $600 worth of bananas on hand. And that means the total inventory is $800, which should be equal to the inventory asset, $800.